The launch date for Flight 8 is getting clearer, heightening anticipation as Pad B nears its final stages of completion. Meanwhile, the Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel has made a major recommendation for NASA's Artemis program, while Japan has achieved another major milestone in space exploration. Let's dive in on today's episode of In Our Studio. It's been 2 weeks since the seventh Starship mission, and anticipation for Flight 8 is at an all-time high, especially considering Flight 7 unmet goals. Undoubtedly, the most important question on everyone's minds is the timing of the upcoming launch. A recent announcement from the Federal Communications Commission has provided substantial early indications, supported by corroborating information from multiple sources, that the SpaceX team is holding out positive prospects for a launch before the end of February. According to the recently disclosed FCC license update, the approved operating window for Flight 8 is set to run from February 2nd to August 2nd, 2025. While this time frame covers a broad spectrum, the main point to note is the launch date, which suggests that Flight 8 will not take off before February 2nd. If this timeline holds, the earliest conceivable launch would be about 3 weeks from now, which would represent a turnaround period that is just over a month since Flight 7. This timeline is logical, reflecting SpaceX's ongoing efforts in post-flight analysis and collaboration with the FAA to manage debris, investigate the reasons behind the spacecraft failure, and implement critical improvements. Efforts to address these issues began immediately after Flight 7. However, both SpaceX and the FAA have withheld additional information. Recent statements have suggested that several engineers and QA personnel at SpaceX were terminated for allegedly bypassing the S-33 verification process in order to meet the launch timeline. Musk has vehemently denied these claims, calling them inaccurate. This suggests that the anomaly that occurred during Flight 7 stemmed from a technical issue and not negligence, while SpaceX diligently implemented all necessary steps to ensure the success of Flight 8. While late February seems like an achievable deadline, a significant number of people are calling for an accelerated release. The positive development is that progress continues to be consistent, with no notable damage reported from the most recent flight. The FAA has implemented procedural enhancements designed to facilitate a more expedient turnaround, thus sustaining optimism for a prompt launch. SpaceX preparations are advancing with remarkable efficiency. The launch system remains subject to ongoing inspections and refurbishment. However, no notable issues have been identified, indicating it could be primed for deployment at any moment. Concurrently on the hardware front, Ship 3 is in the process of being fitted with its engines following the successful completion of cryogenic testing at Massey. Cameron County has declared a temporary road closure on February the 2nd, ostensibly for the movement of either Booster 16 or Ship 3, with the latter appearing to be the more probable candidate. Should this occur, it would signify a pivotal milestone, the static fire test. Upon completion, the vessel will have successfully passed its autonomous evaluations, thereby advancing Flight 8 closer to its launch. Although the launch system is being readied ahead of time, the maneuver of Booster 15 is anticipated to occur subsequently, suggesting that two static fire tests may transpire in the forthcoming weeks. Upon the completion of this phase, SpaceX will require further time to conclude system verifications and installations, which encompass the flight termination system, payload integration, payload dispenser, and modifications for hot staging. Although these supplementary measures may slightly prolong the timeline, they are essential to ensure the mission proceeds smoothly and safety standards are upheld. Considering the current rate of advancement, the objective for the end of February remains achievable. The timeline provided by the FCC serves as an approximation. However, the ultimate authorization for launch hinges on FAA approvals and SpaceX internal preparedness. Musk and the company have refrained from offering additional updates after the post-flight analysis of Flight 7, which has resulted in a degree of ambiguity. Nonetheless, should everything proceed according to plan, a launch in late February would represent an exhilarating milestone. With every Starship launch, SpaceX relentlessly advances the frontiers of space exploration while enhancing the operational efficacy of its spacecraft. Each test yields valuable insights that contribute to the enhancement of designs, the optimization of systems, and the advancement towards the regularity of Starship launches. Although obstacles persist, the swift advancements at Starbase herald the imminent dawn of a new era in space exploration. Meanwhile, SpaceX is making rapid progress not only with the vehicle in Pad A, but also with the adjacent Pad B system. The most significant development to date has been the Mechazilla upgrade. Once lifted into position, the main arm and the blowpipe carriage were deftly integrated. On the afternoon of January 27th, footage was captured of a crane lifting the system onto the tower. The blowpipe carriage was then securely attached to the structure, leading to the removal of the assembly frame, thus indicating its functional completion in the installation procedure. The blowpipe system development is still significantly incomplete. The arm currently shows only preliminary stages, with future modifications anticipated. Welding will increase its dimensions, and additional components, including a pulley system, will be included. Below, construction of the orbital launch cradle system is underway at the Sanchez site, encased in an elaborate scaffolding framework. Nearby, pipes are being carefully hoisted and assembled to construct the fire bucket system. If this momentum continues, the system is expected to be fully assembled before being transported to Pad B for final installation. If this momentum continues, Pad B could be completed by the end of the month, thus facilitating the start of testing. This timeline is consistent with SpaceX's strategy, as Flight 8 is not intended to include the retrieval of Starship. This important milestone is expected to begin with Flight 9, and some analysis suggests that Tower B will serve a critical function at this critical juncture. The highly anticipated dual tower era is now upon us, possibly as early as the first half of this year. Upon its arrival, it will signify a monumental advancement towards complete rocket reusability, accomplished by the globe's most massive rocket. Are you prepared to witness this pivotal juncture in the annals of spaceflight? Additionally, the Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel has expressed reservations regarding NASA's methodology pertaining to the Artemis program, advocating for a reassessment of its mission strategies to alleviate potential risks. On January 30th, the committee advised NASA to reevaluate its existing goals, especially regarding Artemis 3, in order to achieve a more equitable and sustainable risk management approach throughout the program. The agency contends that NASA is imposing an excessive number of challenges on a single mission, thereby threatening its potential for success. Bill Bray, a panel member, emphasized these concerns by stating that each initial milestone presents its own unique risks, and as these risks accumulate and compound, they significantly elevate the overall risk profile for any given flight mission. This prompts a critical inquiry. Should the agency undertake a reassessment of its current mission objectives and strategy for Artemis 3 and subsequent endeavors, aiming to achieve a more equitable distribution of risks across all associated flight tests? The concerns presented are indeed legitimate, as Artemis 3 incorporates numerous innovative components. This mission is designed to showcase the functionality of the Starship lunar lander, evaluate Axiom's innovative spacesuit, and accomplish 13 critical assignments, each posing unique technical and operational hurdles. Furthermore, modifications to the Orion heat shield introduce an additional dimension of uncertainty. The panel's apprehensions encompass upcoming missions, notably Starship's involvement in Artemis, Blue Moon's inaugural appearance in Artemis 5, and the overarching strategy for the Lunar Gateway. Bray underscored the challenges inherent in orchestrating these components, remarking that each element undergoing development and delivery demands nearly flawless execution throughout a multifaceted array of tests and milestones, leaving minimal margin for error. The intricacies of these missions are leading to an increase in both delays and associated risk factors. The panel recommends that NASA draw lessons from the Apollo program, wherein each mission was centered around distinct objectives, thereby facilitating coherent advancement and effective risk management. This methodology facilitated Apollo's consistent progress toward the lunar landing. Another concern lies in the disparate advancement exhibited by the organizations involved. SpaceX has achieved notable advancements with Starship, despite the persistence of certain technical challenges. Blue Origin has indeed advanced, yet the inaugural flight of New Glenn showcased a mix of triumphs and challenges. However, the most pressing challenges come from NASA's existing infrastructure, including the launch system, rocket, and spacecraft, which directly impact the Artemis II schedule. Despite these obstacles, optimism remains, particularly with SpaceX's Starship reaching significant milestones with remarkable consistency. Iterations of Starship's human landing system are making significant progress, bolstering confidence in its functionality for future lunar expeditions. As deliberations progress, the space community remains eagerly awaiting updates from ASAP and NASA on potential substantial modifications to the Artemis program. In today's closing segment of the update, dated February 2nd at 3:30 a.m. Eastern Time, we celebrate the successful launch of a Japanese H-3 rocket from Tanegashima Space Center, marking another significant milestone in the country's aspirations for space exploration. Its primary purpose was to place into orbit the Michibiki 6 satellite, a vital component of Japan's quasi-Zenith satellite system. The launch significantly complements Japan's GPS system, introducing critical functionality to its navigation framework. The 1,900-kilogram Michibiki 6 satellite is poised to complement Japan's GPS infrastructure, providing critical positioning, navigation, and timing services. Positioned at 90.5 degrees east within the geostationary belt, it maintains an orbit 35,786 kilometers above the equator. Michibiki 6 is the latest addition to Japan's growing satellite constellation, replacing the first satellite launched in 2010. Japan is currently considering expanding its satellite system to include 11 satellites for increased redundancy, as articulated in a policy document from the Cabinet Office of Japan, dated 202. The successful launch is a significant milestone for the H-3 rocket, which faced challenges in March 2023 due to a second-stage engine failure. Through this mission, the H-3 has demonstrated its reliability as a cost-effective launch vehicle, ready to engage in the competitive commercial market. Simultaneously, Japan is also charting a course for international efforts, with upcoming launches for UAESat and Eutelsat, underscoring Japan's growing aspirations for global collaboration in space. This effort marks Japan's first rocket launch in 2025, following the significant achievement of deploying the Resilience Lunar Lander with the U.S.'s Blue Ghost via a Falcon 9 rocket. Based on this achievement, Japan is firmly positioning itself as a significant contender in the field of space exploration this year. The successful launch of H-3 underscores Japan's growing prominence in the field of space exploration. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.